It's Shin. Welcome to The Great Kind. Today we are taking a deeper look at vitamin D. Specifically, does it help improve endurance and oxygen uptake? Vitamin D is our body's natural response to sunlight. It's a basic vitamin that we require for the healthy functioning of our bodies. Some of us are vitamin D deficient, and others are unable to stay out in the sun for too long. So vitamin D pills become an alternative.
I'm linking a few studies down below. Most show some kind of correlation of vitamin D with cardiorespiratory fitness. They measured exercise performance, strength, and VO2 max, or maximal oxygen uptake. But studies are inconclusive whether vitamin D supplementation provides benefits to cardiorespiratory fitness.
I had to put it to the test. We are going to do a 60-day blind experiment with controls. We randomly assigned pills to each day and also made sure to evenly distribute them so that we didn't have long stretches or absences of either vitamin D or the control. The pill operator will supply me with 2 pills every day, which I will take first thing in the morning. I will be taking them in this masked up container so that I have no way to tell what pill I am taking per day. I should also note that I've never taken vitamin D pills before, so I have no idea what they look like, taste like, or smell like. All right, time for the experiment. So we are going to be testing 2 correlations, how vitamin D affects endurance and oxygen uptake. To test endurance, I will be running 1 kilometer at top speed and tracking my max heart rate during the run. I'll be using the Nike Run app, which tells me when I'm at 1 kilometer, and it tracks my pace. For the record, I have never run at top speed for 1K before, so I just had no concept of how long 1K is, so I didn't really understand how to pace myself. Now, the first few times I did it, I had to stop myself midway, catch my breath, and then continue on the run. Today was day 1. I thought I had a fantastic run in the rain. It's only like 30 days in, I think, so 30 more days, and I didn't have the best run. Over the 60 days, I did get better at pacing myself, either starting slow and then picking up my pace middle to the end of the run, or keeping a steady, semi-fast pace for the entire run. Still lots of learning to do though. Can't say I've truly nailed it.
Just finished my last run. It's day 60 of 60, yo.
After collecting 60 days of data,
here are the results.
This is what I accomplished on my control days. And here's how vitamin D compares. On average, I ran faster. My top 3 runs of all time were on vitamin D. My max heart rate on the run stayed the same. I feel like I tried to run equally hard every day. On vitamin D, I was able to sustain high speeds longer.
To test oxygen uptake, I will be holding my breath for as long as I can every day. Now, when holding my breath, I did not prep my lungs in any way. What I did was made sure my heart rate was under 75 before beginning the breath hold. For those of you who are interested in increasing your lung capacity without supplements, check out this video.
I'd usually hold my breath at night before going to sleep, 3 to 4 hours after a meal, to avoid variability.
Here are the breath hold results.
These are my breath holds on control days. My longest no-prep breath hold was 93 seconds. Here is vitamin D in comparison. I held my breath longer than 93 seconds 9 times. So does vitamin D work? I ran 1 kilometer 8.8 seconds faster and held my breath 10.6 seconds longer.
Now the question is, will I continue taking vitamin D pills? To be honest, I'm not much of a supplement gal in general, but on days when I know I'm not going to be getting enough sunlight, I might opt in. I bought these vitamin D capsules on Amazon, link down below. The control I was taking was Brahmi or Bacopa Monieri, which helps improve memory. We did an entire different experiment on those pills. Does it work? Find out next week or hit the notification bell to get notified. And that is it from me. I will see you in the next video.